the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Jesus Christ has made us into a kingdom, priests for his God and Father. Grant that being made sharers in Christ's consecration, we may bear witness to your redemption in the world. Christ not only adorns with a royal priesthood the people he has made his own, but he also chooses men to become sharers in his sacred ministry. These are words taken from today's liturgy, from the entrance antiphon, from the collect, and from the preface. They speak of God's kingdom made up of priests, a royal priesthood of all God's people, and a ministerial priesthood conferred through the laying on of hands. Both are essential, both complement each other. By being in communion with Christ, both are in communion with each other, and in Christ form true unity. For the times that we have sinned against the communion and unity of the body of Christ, we ask pardon so that we may worthily celebrate these sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
To God in the highest.
Oh,
God, who anointed your only begotten Son with the Holy Spirit and made him Christ and Lord, graciously grant that being made sharers in his consecration, we may bear witness to your redemption in the world. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. The Spirit of the Lord has been given to me, for the Lord has anointed me. He has sent me to bring the good news to the poor, to bind up hearts that are broken, to proclaim liberty to captives, freedom to those in prison, to proclaim a year of favor from the Lord, a day of vengeance for our God, to comfort all those who mourn, and to give them for ashes a garland, for mourning robe, the oil of gladness, for despondency, praise. But you will be named priests of the Lord. They will call you ministers of our God. I reward them faithfully and make an everlasting covenant with them. Their race will be famous throughout the nations, their descendants throughout the peoples. All who see them will admit that they are a race whom the Lord has blessed. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Reading from the book of the Apocalypse. Grace and peace to you from Jesus Christ, the faithful witness, the firstborn from the dead, the ruler of the kings of the earth. He loves us and has washed away our sins with his blood and made us a line of kings, priests to serve his God and Father. To him, then, be glory and power forever and ever. Amen. It is he who is coming on the clouds. Everyone will see him, even those who pierced him. and all the races of the earth will mourn over him. This is the truth. Amen. I am the Alpha and the Omega, says the Lord God, who is, who was, and who is to come, the Almighty. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus came to Nazareth, where he had been brought up, and went into the synagogue on the Sabbath day as he usually did. He stood up to read, and they handed him the scroll of the prophet Isaiah. Unrolling the scroll, he found the place where it is written, "The Spirit of the Lord has been given to me, for he has anointed me. He has sent me to bring the good news to the poor, to proclaim liberty to captives, and to the blind new sight, to set the downtrodden free, to proclaim the Lord's year of favor." He then rolled up the scroll, gave it back to the assistant, and sat down. And all eyes in the synagogue were fixed on him. Then he began to speak to them. "This text is being fulfilled today, even as you listen." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear brothers and sisters, I'm sorry I forgot to welcome everybody at the very beginning. I was so focused on making sure I knew what was coming next that I forgot to say welcome. You really are welcome to the cathedral for our celebration of this beautiful Mass of Chrism. Yet another year has passed since we gathered here to celebrate this very, very special occasion of the Mass of Chrism. If the liturgy, and in particular the sacrifice of the Mass, is the source and summit of the Church's activity and life, then today's celebration is very much the resource of all our sacramental and priestly activity as God's consecrated people. We gather as the local church of the whole Diocese of Middlesbrough from every corner to give praise and thanks to God and to beg for all the gifts of healing, holiness, and consecration that we'll need in the coming year. In the first reading from Isaiah and quoted by St. Luke in the Gospel, we're reminded that as God's people, we are gifted and endowed, anointed and sent to bring good news, to bind up broken hearts, to proclaim liberty and favour from the Lord, and comfort those who mourn. Did you want to know what the results and implications of our baptism and confirmation are? There you have it. All of us are called to this ministry. In this way, we all share in the mission of Jesus. There are no exceptions among the people of God. This is our common task, given equally to each one of us. Perhaps some of you are just realizing this truth. Perhaps as a result of a form of conversion brought about by listening to the Word of God directly, or mediated to you through the life of someone you know and respect. This truth has suddenly and recently dawned upon you. Share your enthusiasm with us. Let your newly found zeal anoint us all. Tap into the knowledge and experience of a community that has 2,000 years of prayerfully reflected knowledge and experience. Be guided by the Word of God, the teaching tradition of the Church, and her present-day teaching and teachers. Perhaps you've been trying to live this truth for many years, and that first enthusiasm and zeal are now only distant memories, hard to recall. Routine, the knocks of everyday experience, pressure, weariness, age, sickness, all take their toll. If we have not nurtured, guarded, and protected that enthusiasm and zeal, then they can turn sour and become a worldly wise cynicism, a weight in itself to pull us down. This latter situation is a particular temptation for us who have been called to the ministerial priesthood. We've been given the same task and mission as you, but Christ not only adorns with a royal priesthood the people he has made his own, but with a brother's kindness, he also chooses men to become sharers in his sacred ministry through the laying on of hands. It's also our task to renew in his name the sacrifice of human redemption, to set before God's children the Paschal banquet, to lead his holy people in charity, to nourish them with the word, strengthen them with the sacraments. As we give up our lives for the Lord and for the salvation of our brothers and sisters, we are to strive to be conformed to the image of Christ himself and offer to God a constant witness of faith and love. What a high and magnificent calling we have. But as I said, routine, the knocks of everyday experience, pressure, weariness, age, sickness, all take their toll on us. And if we don't nurture and guard and protect that first enthusiasm and zeal, then they can turn sour and become a worldly wise cynicism, a weight in itself to pull us down. In a moment or two, I'm going to call upon my brothers, my brother priests, to renew their ordination promises. And I'm going to ask you all to pray for them and to pray for me. Please take this request very seriously. And hear it as coming from our very hearts. We need your prayerful support. Without it, we're literally at sea and lost. And brothers, If any of you are feeling overburdened by your calling and ministry, if at this moment you find it hard to renew your commitment to priestly promises, look around you. Here is your encouragement. Here is your incentive. This congregation represents the whole people of God praying for each of us today and always. We have the example of Christ, the faithful witness, who brings graces and peace to each of us. We have the prayer of David presented to us in the Psalm at Mass, which each of us should make our own as we turn to the Lord, asking again for his strength and his mercy. You are my Father, my God, the rock who saves me. Yes, we're called to be genuine sons of the Father in the certain knowledge that we are cherished and loved. We're called to be faithful witnesses, witnessing to Christ, his message and mission as proclaimed through the church. It's not our own personal opinion or interpretation. It's primarily not my way of doing things. We're called to be conformed to Christ, who came not to be served, but to serve and give his life as a ransom for many. Wherever any of us find ourselves in this mass of chrism, spiritually or emotionally, whatever we might be feeling or thinking in our hearts and minds, be assured that the Lord will bless and increase whatever small gifts we have to offer him at this Holy Eucharist. Place yourselves on the altar. Together with all the gifts to be brought up at the offertory procession, offer your lives with all that forms them, the good, the bad, and the indifferent. By the power of his Spirit, the Lord will transform us. Make your own the prayer which I'll say over the offerings at this Mass. May the power of this sacrifice, O Lord, we pray, mercifully wipe away what is old in us and increase in us grace of salvation and newness of life. Then we can proclaim with confidence the final words spoken by Jesus at the conclusion of our Gospel. This text is being fulfilled even as we listen. Can I ask my brother priest to stand, please? Beloved sons, on the anniversary of that day when Christ our Lord conferred his priesthood on his apostles and on us, are you resolved to renew in the presence of your bishop and God's holy people the promises you once made? Are you resolved to be more united with the Lord Jesus and more closely conformed to him, denying yourselves and confirming those promises about the sacred duties towards Christ's church, which, prompted by love of him, you willingly and joyfully pledged on the day of your priestly ordination?
Amen.
Are you resolved to be faithful stewards of the mysteries of God in the Holy Eucharist and the other liturgical rites, and to discharge faithfully the sacred office of teaching, following Christ the head and shepherd, not seeking any gain, but moved only by zeal for souls?
Amen.
As for you, dearest sons and daughters, pray for your priests, that the Lord may pour out his gifts abundantly upon them, and keep them faithful as ministers of Christ the High Priest, so that they may lead you to him who is the source of salvation.
Christ, 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 Christ.
And pray also for me, that I may be faithful to the apostolic office entrusted to me in my loneliness, and that in your midst I may be made day by day a living and more perfect image of Christ, the priest, the good shepherd, the teacher, and the servant of all. May the Lord keep us all in his charity and lead all of us, shepherd and flock, to eternal life. Amen.
For Holy Chrism.
The sick.
The oil of catechumens.
Let us sins be put to flight.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his church.
May the power of this sacrifice, O Lord, we pray, mercifully wipe away what is old in us, and increase in us grace of salvation and newness of life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For by the anointing of the Holy Spirit, you made your only begotten Son, High Priest of the new and eternal covenant, and by your wondrous design were pleased to decree that this one priesthood should continue in the Church. For Christ not only adorns with a royal priesthood the people he has made his own, but with a brother's kindness he also chooses men to become sharers in his sacred ministry through the laying on of hands. They are to renew in his name the sacrifice of human redemption, to set before your children the paschal banquet, to lead your holy people in charity, to nourish them with the word, and strengthen them with the sacraments. As they give up their lives for you and for the salvation of their brothers and sisters, they strive to be conformed to the image of Christ himself and offer a constant witness of faith and love. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim. Gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and giving thanks, he gave it a blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven. And as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, Terence Patrick, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you've gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you've summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Most Reverend Father, we present this oil to you. We ask you to bless it, for the anointing of those who are sick, to give them comfort, healing, and strength.
O God, Father of all consolation, who will to heal the infirmities of the weak through your Son, listen favorably to the prayer of faith. Send forth from the heavens, we pray, your Holy Spirit, the Paraclete, upon this oil in all its richness, which you have graciously brought forth from the verdant tree to restore the body, so that by your holy blessing, everyone anointed with this oil as a safeguard for body and soul and spirit may be freed from all pain, all infirmity, and all sickness. May your holy oil, O Lord, be blessed by you for our sake, in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, keep me safe for eternal life. Amen.
I will sing forever.
Let us pray. We beseech you, Almighty God, that those you renew by your sacraments may merit to become the pleasing fragrance of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Most Reverend Father, we present this oil to you. We ask you to bless it for those who are preparing for baptism, that they may be anointed with the oil of salvation, in the name of Christ our Saviour.
O God, strength and protection of your people, who have made the oil you created a sign of strength, graciously bless this oil, and grant courage to the catechumens who will be anointed with it, so that, receiving divine wisdom and power, they may understand more deeply the gospel of your Christ, that they may undertake with a generous heart the labors of the Christian life, and made worthy of adoption as your sons and daughters, may rejoice to be born anew and to live in your church through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Most Reverend Father, we present this oil to you. We ask you to consecrate it for the celebration of the sacraments of baptism, confirmation, and holy orders, and for the dedication of the altars for the celebration of the Eucharist.
Let us pray that God, our Almighty Father, will bless this oil so that all who are anointed with it may be inwardly transformed and come to share in eternal salvation. God, our Maker, source of all growth and holiness, accept the joyful thanks and praise we offer in the name of your Church. In the beginning, at your command, the earth produced fruit-bearing trees. From the fruit of the olive tree, you have provided us with oil for Holy Chrism. The prophet David sang of the life and joy that the oil would bring us in the sacraments of your love. After the avenging flood, the dove returning to Noah with an olive branch announced your gift of peace. This was a sign of a greater gift to come. Now the waters of baptism wash away the sins of all people, and by the anointing with olive oil, you make us radiant with your joy. At your command, Aaron was washed with water, and your servant Moses, his brother, anointed him priest. This too foreshadowed greater things to come. After your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, asked John for baptism in the waters of Jordan, you sent the Spirit upon him in the form of a dove, and by the witness of your own voice, you declared him to be your only well-beloved Son. In this, you clearly fulfilled the prophecy of David that Christ would be anointed with the oil of gladness beyond all his fellow. And so, Father, we ask you to bless this oil you have created. Fill it with the power of your Holy Spirit, through Christ your Son. It is from him that Chrism takes its name, and with Chrism you have anointed for yourself priests and kings, prophets and martyrs. Make this Chrism a sign of life and salvation for those who are to be born again in the waters of baptism. Wash away the evil they have inherited from sinful Adam, and when they are anointed with this holy oil, make them temples of your glory, radiant with the goodness of life that has its source in you. Through this sign of chrism, grant them royal, priestly, and prophetic honor, and clothe them with incorruption. Let this be indeed the chrism of salvation for those who will be born again of water and the Holy Spirit. May they come to share eternal life in the glory of your kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Most Reverend Father Terence Patrick Drainey, by the grace of God and the Apostolic See, Bishop of this Holy Church of Middlesbrough, will give the apostolic blessing with a plenary indulgence in the name of the Roman Pontiff to all present who are truly penitent and have confessed their sins and received Holy Communion. Pray God for our Most Holy Father, Pope Francis, our Bishop Terence Patrick, and for Holy Mother Church, and strive by holiness of life to walk in full communion with it.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Through the intercession of the blessed apostles Peter and Paul, may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thanks be to God.